Hey everybody, David Barnes here with another episode of ET Info, where I bring you information on new and emerging technologies from IBM. It's been a while since I made a BlueMix video, and since that time, there has been an incredible amount of change. BlueMix now is in a public beta. The user interface has changed. There are all sorts of new services, and so that's what I want to show you in this video. As a recap, BlueMix is a place for developers to go to quickly develop, create, deploy, and manage applications in the cloud. In the spirit of cloud naming conventions, let's see, today we have infrastructure as a service, platform as a service, software as a service, backend as a service, mobile backend as a service. I'm going to name what I do now, and I'm coining the phrase here, DAS, demos as a service. So let me pull down my green screen and I'll give you a look at BlueMix. So here I am at BlueMix.net. If I scroll down, one of the things that you'll see is that this user interface is attractive. It's not like our normal IBM user interfaces, which are often less than attractive. Before I go any further, I need to point out, why did we create BlueMix? Well, the traditional IT development cycle for applications is just too slow. If I want to go off and create a new application just to try it, I may have to buy hardware. That's capital. That takes a long time. I might need to buy a big monolithic chunk of software that, if the application doesn't work out for me, it hits the virtual shelf. Instead, I'll show you the BlueMix approach. For this scenario, as an application developer, HR came to me and they said, "Hey, David, can you create an application so that our employees can go out to their friends on LinkedIn and say, hey, we're hiring. Are you interested in, you know, putting your name in the hat here and applying for the job?" Then that information is gathered from LinkedIn with their permission, and it's put into a database and then an HR dashboard so HR can see who's applied. As the developer, the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go up and select Catalog. Here you can see a lot of different boilerplates that are available, different runtimes, different frameworks, different services that are available. Some are IBM-created services. Some are IBM-certified services that are from third-party partners like Twilio and, in this case, Pitney Bowes. Some of them are community-created services. This services palette is growing every day. For my application, I'm going to use Node. Now, you'll notice Java is there. You can use Java, absolutely, but you don't have to. You can use Node, but you don't have to. You choose the framework of your choice. You use the programming language of your choice. Whatever helps you create your applications more quickly. For me, I'm going to select Node. It says, "Do you want to create an application?" I say yes. It says, "Let's give this application a name," and I'm going to call this LI Outreach, for LinkedIn Outreach. Notice the host name and the domain name at the bottom. That's the name, the URL, where I go to when I'm done with my application. It'll be running there. When I select Create, this is where all the goodness really starts to happen for me, the application developer. BlueMix just provisioned an instance of Node. It's up and running and available for me to use. Now, I should mention, I just compressed time a little bit in the video. That took about 30 seconds for this to be provisioned and ready for me to go. What I didn't have to do, I didn't have to create a virtual machine. I didn't have to configure memory, configure infrastructure software, or deal with routers, or beg someone in IT for a domain name. Instead, I'm ready to go. In the upper right-hand corner, there's this little notification center. I don't know if that's what it's really called. That's what I'm calling it. On the top here, it says, "Get started with your application." When I click on that, it gives me a little bit of information on how to get going. There's a download the starter application package. So I'm going to download that linked file. It's sort of a Hello World application to get me started with my code. And now I'm off and running. I'm going to go up and click. Again, I don't know the name for this either. I'm just calling it the bug. Click that, get it out of the way. I have Node running. In and of itself, it's not going to do much for me. So I'm going to go down, scroll down. I'll add a new service. And in this case, the gentleman that created this application on our team, Karl Azapov, he added some security. with Secure Sign-On. So I say I want to add that to the application, choose the application name, select Create, and that's it. BlueMix just created an instance of that service, and it is now bound to that Node application that I've already got running. He added one more. We needed someplace a database. I'll add the service here. We needed a database to put the LinkedIn profiles that we grab, and so he used Cloudant for that. I could add the Cloudant database instance, same as I just did with the other. Instead, let me close that down. I'm going to switch over to the completed version that Carl created. I'll scroll down here. You've got the application is there, the services are there, and it's ready for him to go and write code. I'll switch over to this tab and point out something very important. I make this stuff look so slick. It's not mashups. It is not just wire things together. You still have to be a software developer. It's for people that write software for a living. Here, I can use, if I want JazzHub, JazzHub's from Rational in IBM. If I want to write my code here, I can click Deploy. It says, hey, what's your IBM address for BlueMix and what's the password? And it pushes the code back up into BlueMix. If I say, nope, I'm an Eclipse user, write your code in Eclipse however you are most efficient, however you want to write your code, and then you push it back up into BlueMix. It's all up to y'all. Now, I didn't say that. Oh my gosh, I did. Okay, I'm a Chicagoan. I live in Texas, but I am a Chicagoan. Here's a story. I was presenting at a Hadoop users group. I used to work on big data analytics. And after I got done presenting, this gentleman, he saunters up. He didn't walk. He saunters up. He's got this big old Texas cowboy head. He's got a belt buckle the size of a hubcap. I swear must have weighed 7 pounds. He looks at me. He says, son, he says, you know that big data y'all talking about? This is down here in Texas. We just call it data. No, that's not true at all. I made that up. But so I write my software. I push it back up into BlueMix. When I switch back over here, there's Carl's application again. It's up and running. It's not magic, but we talked about this on a Thursday. Carl showed us the first rev of it on a Monday. We could not have done that using the old school approach. We'd still be begging somebody in IT for a domain name. Instead, he got it up and running quickly. If you scroll down here, there is the URL for the application, LinkedIn Outreach. I click on that. It launches the application. This is what our employees can send out to their friends. They see this, say, yeah, I'm interested in a job. They click up here, sign in with their LinkedIn user ID and password. Again, they're opting in here. It says, hey, if you do this, we're going to gather your profile information, et cetera, all with the LinkedIn API. Yeah, sounds good to me. I allow access, and that's it. We just pull the information, we put it in the Cloudant database. Then we make it available for the business user. This is the HR dashboard. HR goes and sees, hey, these are the people that are interested in the job. These look like highly qualified people, except for that one up on the top. If they want to go further, they can click on the LinkedIn profile and go directly to the LinkedIn page. The application is done and in the hands of the user. I go back over here into BlueMix and I say, you know what, I can add another service if I wanted to, if we want to change this application. Or let's go into this instance of Node that's running and click down here and say, you know what, this thing's been really popular. It's really expanding. I want it to grow. I can go and say, I want more instances running. I can say, I want more memory allocated to it. And that immediately allocates more memory, more instances, because we're built on Cloud Foundry. We have all of the elasticity that Cloud Foundry promises. Now, as I said before, I make this look all sweet and simple, but it's still about writing software, but the time savings is incredible. I'll be making more videos. Notice I went really, really fast here. Everybody wants short videos, so you can consider this one, brought to you by Monster Energy Drink. I'll be making more videos. I'll put them out on youtube.com/IBMETinfo. If you want to go out and check out BlueMix on your own, BlueMix.net. And if you're interested in engaging with us around a project around BlueMix, a group on our team called JSTART helps jumpstart customers on proof of concepts around cloud, BlueMix, etc. You can visit their website at ibm.com/JSTART.